In this video, we're going to solve this equation. 3 to the power of square root x minus 6 plus 9 to the power of square root x minus 6 equals 2 over x minus 5. Then how to solve this equation? We're going to start from this square root. Because for square root, it's always bigger than or equal to 0. So that means the inside part x minus 6 is bigger than or equal to 6. So that means x is bigger than or equal to 6. Then we label this one as result 1. Next, we're going to start from the left-hand side of the equation. Then here, the left-hand side of the equation, 3 to the power of square root x minus 6 plus 9 to the power of square root x minus 6. Because the minimum value for square root is 0. So if we use 0 replace here and use 0 replace here, then here is bigger than or equal to 3 to the power 0, then plus 9 to the power of 0. So then we have the left-hand side of the equation. 3 to the power x minus 6 plus 9 to the power of square root x minus 6 is bigger than or equal to this one simplified, that's 2. Because the left-hand side of the equation is bigger than or equal to 2, that means the right-hand side of the equation is also bigger than or equal to 2. Then here, the right-hand side of the equation, 2 over x minus 5 is also bigger than or equal to 2. So next, we need to solve this inequality. But before we do that, we need to determine the sign of x minus 5. Because based on the result 1, x is bigger than or equal to 6. So that means for x minus 5, because x is bigger than or equal to 6, then x minus 5 is bigger than 0. So next, then both sides are multiplied by x minus 5. Then the left-hand side is 2. Because x minus 5 is positive, it's bigger than 0. So then when both sides times x minus 5, so the inequality sign stays the same. Then here, still bigger than or equal to. Then 2 times x minus 5. Then both sides cancel out the 2. Then we have x minus 5 less than or equal to 1. And x less than or equal to 6. Then we label this one as result 2. So now let's combine result 1 with the result 2. So now let's take a look. So this is a result 1. X bigger than or equal to 6. So then combine the two results by result 1. Then x is bigger than or equal to 6. Then by result 2, then x less than or equal to 6. So here we have x bigger than or equal to 6, less than or equal to 6. So that means x can only be 6. So 6 is the only solution of this equation. Thanks for watching.